Hey, what's up, everybody? Oh, happy Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas Eve. This is a complimentary quad, man. Gonna be doing a complimentary quad featuring some Southern rock. And gonna be starting off with Dixie Chicken by Little Feet, followed by Keep On Smiling by Wet Willie. Followed by Can't You See by the Marshall Tucker Band, and then finally Back Up Against the Wall by the Atlantic Rhythm Section. So I just want to give a shout out and a thanks very much to Jeff. Thanks very much, man. Thanks for sending me the recommendations and the link, and yeah, it was a little while ago, so thank you also for your patience, man, and not pestering the hell out of me. Jeff has a note here. He goes, hey, man, how about a quad of random Southern rock? 3! Here are some of my favorites. 3! I hope you enjoy. Jeff. Thanks, Jeff. I appreciate it, man. Obviously, you're a fan of Southern rock. And I am too, man. I've been getting a good dose of it with a couple of different quads here and there. And also too, with the Allman Brothers being Artist of the Month. I know some of you don't consider them to be Southern rock, but I do. I consider that their sound has definitely a great Southern rock flavoring to it. Not all encompassing, but it definitely has some flavoring to it. Maybe one of those reasons why I like the Allman Brothers so much, because I really like the Southern rock sound. The body of rock and roll all encompassing, Southern rock is just a big part of that appealing charm to me. And a year later, I still can't define why, but it just, it's kind of like attracting a moth to a flame for some reason. It just brings me, it reels me in. Anyway, we're not going to break down and analyze that. Let's just get on with it, man. We're going to start off with Little Feet and Dixie Chicken. All right, Little Feet, Dixie Chicken. Let's get it. Oh, it's life. Thank you. taking a good man for all that he's got. Instrumental break right in the middle of the song there.
Thank you. as he ran away. Guess that guitar player sure could play. She always liked to sing along. She's always handy with a song. And then one night in the lobby, yeah, of the Commodore Hotel, I chanced to meet a bartender who said he knew her well. And as he handed me a drink, he began to hum a song. And all the boys there at the bar
in the bar. Yo, man. Is that the end of the song? Damn. Hey, was it supposed to cut off like that, or do I have a faulty link or something? Let me know about that, if that was supposed to cut out like that. Man, great tune, but yeah, I'm not sure about the ending, man. Fantastic song, though. Holy cow, man, it's got so much life in it. It extends and it expands and it takes you along. They keep you engaged and waiting for the rest of the story. Yo, fantastic storytelling here, man. Excellent, great, entertaining, plus a live rendition. Yo, man, really, really excellent tune. Wow. Dixie Chicken by Little Feet. Yeah, I gotta do more Little Feet, man. I think I've only done, what, maybe, if I'm lucky, even a handful of songs by Little Feet. But it's scattered all over the last 40-odd complimentary quads. But one of the things I appreciate about complimentary quads since I started doing them is the different areas that I'm being taken into. I don't mind being stretched, which is really, really nice. And I, thankfully, I've got a lot of patrons and subscribers who look out for me when I'm being stretched way too far out of range in remote places. I'm not astute enough to know when that's happening, and then I kind of sometimes see in the comment section someone will say, hey, yo, it's a little selfish on your part. You're stretching this guy way, way too far out into remote areas. Let him get the centralized stuff first, and then later on there's time for that. So thanks for being a police where that's concerned. But in saying that, though, I really appreciate the variety that comes to me through complimentary quads, which is excellent. You know, Artist of the Month, for example, you're focusing on one artist, and most of the artists for Artist of the Month are mainstay artists. They're really big, successful artists. And so, yeah, of course, it's great to get to know these particular artists. But let's say Little Feet, for example, if Little Feet never becomes Artist of the Month, at least I get to touch on a little bit of what they're about and get to know them, because I know that a lot of people hold them in very high regard. And it's a question of, well, why is that? So I'm getting to see that. So those complimentary quads are really, really excellent. And I really appreciate the complimentary quad format. And I don't know why I didn't think of starting it sooner. That's the only question. Anyway, man, hey, it is a complimentary quad. And I, my goal is to keep complimentary quads to around 40 to 45 minutes, definitely under an hour. And so if I go off on my talking, then that never happens, man. So let's get into some structure here, man. Do a little bit of reading. Dixie Chicken. Okay, so it's also an album. So it isn't a lot of song info. Let's read it. There's two paragraphs here, two short paragraphs. Dixie Chicken. Dixie Chicken is the third studio album by American rock band Little Feat, released in 1973. The artwork for the front cover was by illustrator Neon Park and is a reference to a line from the album's third track, the song Roll 'em Easy. The album is considered their landmark album, with the title track as their signature song that helped further define the Little Feat sound. This was augmented by two additional members, guitarist Paul Barrier and percussionist Sam Clayton, added to make the more complete and familiar lineup that continued until their 79 breakup following the death of Lowell George. Bassist Kenny Gradney was brought in to replace original bassist Roy Estrada, who had left after the band's second album, Sailing Shoes, to join Captain Beefheart's Magic Band. I've never heard of Captain Beefheart. This new lineup radically altered the band's sound, leaning toward more New Orleans R&B and funk. The song was voted number 563 in Colin Larkin's all-time top 1,000 albums. The album was voted number 563 in Colin Larkin's all-time top 1,000 albums, third edition in 2000. The song is of the I've Been There variety. The story is of a man who meets the woman he believes is the love of his life in the lobby of the Commodore Hotel and immediately makes a lifetime commitment to her, promising her the storied house on the edge of town with the white picket fence. But in the end, she leaves him crying in his beer. The narrator is telling his story to a bartender about how much he loved her and how badly he misses her. Then, one at a time, other guys in the bar start adding to his story until he realizes they'd all been scammed by the same girl. In the end, they're all singing in harmony about the Dixie Chicken and having a wistful but hearty laugh about all being part of this well-populated men's club. Wow, what a script for a movie. The all-female country group, the Dixie Chicks, took their name from this song. Okay, and that I never knew. All right, man, so that is song fact info on Dixie Chicken. Great tune, fantastic tune. Nice extended jams in the middle, breaking up the song, stretching it out. I love that. I dig that a lot, man. Alright, so, let's bounce to our second track, man, and that being Keep On Smiling by Wet Willie. Oh, man, who thought of the name for that band, Wet Willie? There's got to be a story behind that. Alright, man, Wet Willie, Keep On Smiling. Let's get it.
Too busy drinking anyway. You gotta keep on smiling.
country man. Yeah, try to build your life with your hand and just keep on smiling. Keep on smiling.
That bass jam though. Excellent, excellent jam. Had every single thing in it that you could possibly want. Yo, that bass guitar, man, was just talking to me, boy. Let me tell you, that was excellent, man. Keep on smiling, Wet Willie. Some good advice in there, too. Trying to find yourself, figure out who you are, man. You know, don't let shit get you down. You just keep it moving. Keep on smiling, right? The sun's gonna come out again. Excellent, excellent, man. Had a little bit of everything in there. Heard a little piano, heard a little organ. Nice little silhouette of kind of like a choir background. Lead singer, man. Great, great singing voice. Crisp, clear, easy to understand. Tight instrumentation. You, man. What can you say? What an excellent, excellent jam. Fantastic. I remember this being recommended to me as part of my One Hit Wonder series. And if you'll notice that I haven't been doing a lot of One Hit Wonders, it started off okay. And then I kept getting these messages like, yo, man, do your damn research. These guys aren't One Hit Wonders, you know. And so I stopped doing One Hit Wonders mainly because I get these recommendations. And turns out that whoever I'm covering is not a one-hit wonder. So I got tired of that shit, man. You know, so I stopped doing the one-hit wonder series. But I remember this from Wet Willie being recommended to me as one-hit wonder. And I bet you that they're not one-hit wonders. You know what I'm saying? So even though it was a good idea and it started off good, the one-hit wonders, in my opinion, isn't a colossal failure. But I don't think I'm just going to be doing it anymore because I just keep getting these, yo, do your research, they're not one-hit wonders. I hate that shit, man. So, anyway, hey, on to this. Great, fantastic song, man. Great, great song. It's been, oh, I don't know how long it's been since I heard this too, man. A long-ass time ago. Now, it's one of those really great forgotten songs. And, well, by me, I imagine that, you know, if you're really into your Southern rock and whatnot, it's probably a part of your playlist that you maybe listen to every day. So, sorry if I'm insulting anyone there. But, yeah, man, excellent song all the same. So let's do a little read here, man. Keep on smiling. Yeah, okay, so not a lot of info here. So, yeah, so I've got a little song info, a touch of album info, and then an all music review, another short one. So it's pretty much two short paragraphs, so let's check it out. Keep On Smiling is a 1974 hit song by American group Wet Willie. It was the title track of their third studio album. Wet Willie is an American band from Mobile, Alabama. Their best-known song, Keep On Smiling, reached number 10 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 chart in August of 74. Several other of the group's songs also appeared on the singles charts in the 70s, which utilized their soulful brand of Southern rock. See? Yeah, so they're not one-hit wonders. The song was also their first of three top 40 singles and became their greatest hit. Keep On Smiling is ranked as the 66th biggest hit of 1974. It also charted in Canada. Okay, it doesn't say where it charted. And here's an all music review by Bruce Etter. Keep On Smiling is the definitive Wet Willie studio album, bluesier than a lot of their other work, and much of it also somewhat more laid back. Beginning with the country side of life, the band sounds tight, tuned, and in top form. Their playing is clean and crisp, and the vocals exude a bold confidence. Absolutely, love the vocals. The hit title track is a compelling reggae country meld that's one of the more interesting and long wearing country rock hits of its period. It's surrounded by gospel flavored material and also one of the neater Stax influenced tracks ever put down by a white band. And that is a review by All Music's Bruce Etter. All right, man, yo, great song. Fantastic. It'll really get things popping at a party. You kick it off with this, yo. You know, you'll definitely be expecting great things to come. Excellent. So let's bounce to our third track, man. And that being Can't You See? All right, Marshall Tucker Band, Can't You See? Let's get it. Oh, another live performance.
What's that woman? What's she gonna do to me? Can't you see?
another blast from the past. I remember the verse. Or the chorus, man.
I'm gonna buy a ticket as far as I can. I ain't a never coming back. I'm gonna take her that southbound, ride it all the way to Georgia, love, till the train it run out of track. Can't you see?
Damn.
Oh, can't you see?
Brothers defeated.
What I'm gonna spend on you. Can't you see? Can't you see? What I'm gonna spend on me. Play the blues. What's that woman? Oh, spend on me. Let's clap along now. Come on. Can't you see? Make some racket. Can't you see? Sounding good. What's that woman? Oh, spend on me. Yeah. All right.
Can't you see?
Oh, Lord, she's such a crazy kind of lady.
What's that woman?
Oh, spend on me. Go kick it out. I can stand it too much longer, yeah.
What that woman?
Oh, spend on me. All right, you got it.
Can't you see?
Oh, Lord, I'm gonna take a freight train.
Can't you see?
Down at the station.
What that woman?
Ain't I never coming back.
Can't you see?
I'm gonna take her down to southbound.
Can't you see?
Ride it all the way to Georgia.
I think I know why I like Southern rock so much. If I'm thinking about it, asking myself the question, and it's in my head right now. I like the soulfulness of it, the spirit of its delivery, if I can kind of coin a phrase from how I describe Led Zeppelin sometimes. The soulfulness of it, the storytelling aspect, and the instrumentation. Those three things combined gives me this really nice kind of, I don't know, you can call it Southern comfort feeling. And it's attractive as hell. It just draws you in. I think if I had to try and put it into some form, that's why I like Southern rock so much. It's like a familiarity coming home kind of feeling, you know? And that's what Southern rock music, that's how it makes me feel. And it always puts me visually kind of like on a nice long country road, country drive sort of thing. That's why you see a lot of country drive images in the background. But usually when I'm playing some sort of southern rock, something like that with an appeal to it, that's why you see the background so often in the background of my videos. Man, what a great song. Man, I've heard this tune already before, and it just didn't connect to what the song was until I started to hear the chorus of the song. Yeah, and another one, just like Keep On Smiling before this, that I hadn't heard in such a long time. And it's great now to connect who sings it and the memory associated to the fact that I do know it, you know? Excellent. I love connecting those dots, man. All right, so. Excuse the frog in my throat. Try to clear it. And let's do a little read here, man, for Can't You See? Can't You See? Can't You See is a song written by Toy Caldwell of the Marshall Tucker Band. The song was originally recorded by the band on their 73 debut album, The Marshall Tucker Band, and released as the album's first single. It was re-released in 77 and peaked at number 75 on the Billboard Hot 100. Cover versions of Can't You See have charted for Waylon Jennings in 76 and the Zac Brown Band with Kid Rock in 2010. Yeah, I thought that it would have peaked higher than 75. But hey, it charted anyway. This became the anthem song for the Marshall Tucker Band, similar to Free Bird for Lynyrd Skynyrd. It was never a top 40 hit, but was very popular on album-oriented radio, and continues to get a lot of airplay on classic rock stations. The open is unusual. It starts with the picking of a guitar and the playing of a flute. Jerry Eubanks of the Marshall Tucker Band played the flute, giving the song a very distinctive sound. It's not a common instrument in the world of Southern rock. I'm thinking of Canned Heat. I remember they played the flute. Going Up the Country, I believe, was the song. This was featured in the soundtrack for the movie Blow. Yeah, Blow. Great movie, man. Johnny Depp, one of his best performances in that. There is no Marshall Tucker in the Marshall Tucker Band. They saw the name on a key ring where they used to rehearse and decided it would make a good name for their band. The song was named number one greatest Southern rock song ever recorded by Ultimate Classic Rock, with Sweet Home Alabama as runner-up. Said the site, quote, "Next time you hear this song in public, take notice and you'll make the strangest observation, especially if there is booze involved. There seems to be something about this particular song that makes the majority, very ironically, close their eyes and sway their head from left to right while singing the song's famous Can't You See line. That universal connection earns this song the top spot on our Southern rock songs list," unquote. Yeah, I can see that. I can completely see that. And yeah, you add a little alcohol to it and, you know, your frame becomes relaxed. You'll definitely sway your head back and forth with eyes closed, for sure, man. Yeah, music has a powerful, powerful universal appeal. And yeah, it'll definitely inspire. All right, man. So that's Can't You See, Marshall Tucker Band. I've had recommendations to do this a number of times, and now that I'm thinking about it, I'm glad I finally got to it. All right, man. So let's check out our final track, and that being Back Up Against the Wall by Atlanta Rhythm Section. All right, man. Back Up Against the Wall, Atlanta Rhythm Section. Let's get it.
This tonight, you folks are going to be on a live album. How about
it? Another live rendition.
Thank you.
great story being told. They sound really, really excellent in a live setting. That was excellent. What a great song, man. Tells a good story. Got that Southern rock appeal, man. Telling great stories. You know what I was thinking as I was listening to this song? I can't remember the movie. I think it's got Jude Law in it. And it's about someone or a couple of guys escaped from jail. And along their path, their escape route, they came upon a cottage. And the cottage was occupied by a number of attractive women. So, of course, they decided to chill out and hang out overnight with these ladies. And it turns out that these ladies were basically, you know, just a draw. And they were apprehended promptly the next morning because that was a plant by the authorities, knowing that the men would probably stick around. And it slowed them down enough for them to catch up to them and apprehend them. I can't remember the name of the movie, but that's what I was thinking about as this person is describing, "Hey, honey, I'm outside your window. Open up and let me stay for a while. I can't stay long." Well, I bet you the police are probably waiting for him. Anyway, the things you think about when you're listening to music. That's what I was thinking about. Damn, what's the name of that movie now? I can't remember. But yeah, oh man, all of these tunes, all four of these tracks are fantastic. They have a great Southern rock appeal to them. They all tell excellent stories. And the musicianship, the singing, all of that stuff is just really on point. I think Southern rock just has everything that I like in music in general. It's got the rock sound, it's got guitars, it's got lots of harmony. And I think it's also the vocal delivery of the singers as well. They all have these great manly voices. I'm thinking of Lynyrd Skynyrd. I'm thinking of some of these great Southern rock bands, you know. Still trying to put a finger on why I like Southern rock so much, but it's all of those reasons and probably a lot more. That's why I haven't been able to really pin it down. This is the closest I've ever come to actually pinning it down in this particular reaction. I've only in the past commented that I really like Southern rock. Can't figure out why. I'm gonna have to think about it. But yeah, this is the closest I've ever come to actually pinning down why, man. All right, so back up against the wall, man. Let's do a quick read here. And okay, so not a lot of info, just a touch on the song and just a touch on the band. And there's a user review, so let's read those. Back Up Against the Wall is the second album, the first with Ronnie Hammond on lead vocals, by the Southern rock band Atlanta Rhythm Section, released in 73. The album was re-released in 73 with the first Atlanta Rhythm Section album as a double album on MCA's label MCA 24114. Atlanta Rhythm Section, or ARS, is an American Southern rock band formed in 1970 by Rodney Gesto, the singer, Barry Bailey, guitar, Paul Goddard, bass, Dean Doherty, keyboards, Robert Nix, drums, and James B. Cobb Jr. on guitar. The band's current lineup consists of Doherty and Gesto, along with guitarist David Anderson and Steve Stone, and bassist J. Dennis Hawley. Wow, so they're still around, still doing their thing. Okay, different lineup. I'm sure some of these guys are